This is a practice run for researchers at the University of Louisville. They're taking what they already know about drying and rehydrating blood and figuring out if it can be done in space.
Okay, we're into parabola one. Brett is doing the injection of the water.
This practice session on Earth at UofL is in preparation for a NASA-sponsored zero-gravity test flight carrying the UofL researchers and their dried blood.
The question comes up is if you're in reduced gravity or zero gravity, will the red blood cells rehydrate correctly? And will they function like normal red blood cells, transporting oxygen to the tissues of the body where they're needed?
Right now in the first flight campaign of this project, we're identifying whether or not microgravity impacts the rehydration dynamics of red blood cells that have been dried.
This is video from inside the zero-G parabolic spaceflight. That's the UofL team huddled around what looks like an incubator. They're injecting water into the bags of dried blood to see what happens in space. Should, for instance, four astronauts lose blood and need transfusions on a two-year mission to Mars.
So if cosmic radiation reduces the red blood cell count, for example, you're not going to have a donor and a recipient. You're going to have four people needing blood. And there's no good way to store it with a freezer or refrigerator during that long trip. A Mars trip, for example, will be about 2 years. So being able to stably store it in the dried state, but then confidently rehydrated is critical.
What the UofL researchers and students found, besides it's fun to bounce around in zero gravity, is massaging the bag worked in smoothly rehydrating a small amount of dried blood.
We did direct experiment looking at the oxygen carrying capacity of our rehydrated blood, and it seems that that was fine, that that was comparable to what we find when we are rehydrating our blood at ambient or one Earth gravity.
That's good.
Yeah, that's really good. I was really excited.
Now the UofL team will be practicing again for another zero-G flight, this one with a larger amount of blood on board.
The next step is scaling up for our next flight campaign, seeing if our hand mix method will perform as well if we are now looking at like 20, 30 times the volume, so that we are approaching a unit of packed red blood cells when it is infused into a patient.
Can we have fresh red blood cells to transfuse the injured astronaut if in fact that's needed?